Father God, we worship you, Jesus. Father God, we worship you, Jesus. Mashanta, give the worship Father God, we worship you, Jesus. 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 Father God, we wor We are grateful, Father. We are grateful unto you. You have looked at us, your children. You have looked at us, your children, and you have had mercy upon us. And you have said this day that these ones have been expecting. It has finally come. Father God, we pray for you. Oh, my son, Father God, you are worthy to be praised, God. You are worthy to be adored. Father God, who is like God to you? Who is like God unto you? Who is like God unto you? Who is like God unto you? You are the lion, you are the lamb. You are Father, you are help. You are help. Father God, you are the Holy Spirit, you have been our helper. Oh Jesus, you have been our intercessor. Father God, we thank you. When we could not do anything, when we are tired now, but still you give us strength. Thank you, oh God. Thank you, oh God. When challenges came, and it seemed like how we did happen, Father God, Lord God, you see elders, oh God, you speak all the way for us, for this day to be here. Father God, we say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father God, I say 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 thank you, Jesus. Father God, we say thank you, O Lord. We say thank you, O Lord. We say thank you, O Lord. Father God, we say thank you. For all our sisters, God, thank you for being God. We say thank you, Father. We say thank you, Father. We just want to say thank you, Jesus. We are grateful, God. Father God, we are grateful, God.
Father God, we worship you, Jesus.
Amen. We're still going to be thanking God, but we're going to be thanking God for the things he will do. So we're going to thanking God for, I don't know, the expectations that you have for this gathering, for yourself, for your family, for your family, for your friends. I want us to start thanking God for those expectations that we already have. I want to say, God, thank you because you are going to move mightily in my life. Thank you, you are going to move mightily in our fellowship. Thank you that you are going to change something in our lives. Thank you that you are going to start healing people. Thank you, you are going to change situations around. Thank you because you are going to give joy to people. Thank you, you are sending peace to the lives of people. Thank you because you are increasing altars. Thank you because you are sustaining altars. You are keeping the fire upon the altar. Just to thank him for the expectations that we have. Thank you because you are going to bless my life. By the virtue of this meeting, thank you are going to change something in my life. Thank you are going to be thank you because this is going to be the move, beginning of the move of the Lord. It's going to be the beginning of the move of the Lord, the mighty move, Lord God of the Lord, over our lives. Over our families, over our friends, over our Russia, oh Lord God, in our cities, oh God. Thank you because you are starting a revival.
Thank you, oh God, for the greatness you are going to do today.
Thank you because you are starting the beginning of a big move of God. You are starting a move of God. A revival, Lord God. Thank you, oh Jesus, because in this place, you are keeping men. For the promotion of our head, for this country, for our destinies. Father God, we say thank you for our cities, oh God. Father God, we thank you. We are thanking you, oh God. We mother boss shepherd, get the 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 boss shep Father God, we thank you, Father God, thank you. We thank you, oh Lord God. Father God, we say thank you, Jesus. Amen. I'm going to be reading from the book of Hebrews 12:18 to the end. It's a very, very long, like 10 verses, but I want us to just follow. I'm going to be reading NLT so it's easy for us to understand. So you have not come to a physical mountain, to a place of flaming fire, darkness, gloom, and whirlwind, as the Israelites did in Mount Sinai, for they heard the awesome trumpets, blasts. And let me just 21. Moses himself was frightened at the sight, and he said, "I am terrified and trembling." 20. Say, "No, you have come to the Mount Zion, to the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, to the countless thousands of angels in joyful gathering. You have come to the assembly of God's firstborn children, whose names have been written in heaven. You have come to God Himself." These are the things that God is telling us. You have come to God Himself, who is the judge of all things. And we have come to the spirit of the righteous ones in heaven, who have now been made perfect. Now we have come to Jesus Christ, who mediates the new covenant between God and the people, and to the sprinkled blood, which speaks of forgiveness, instead of crying out for vengeance like the blood of Abel. Be careful that you do not refuse to listen to the one who is speaking. For if people of Israel do not escape when they refuse to listen to Moses, the earthly messenger, we will certainly not escape if we reject the one who speaks to us from heaven. When God spoke from Sinai, his voice shook the earth. But now he makes another promise. I want us to listen. "Once again, I will shake not only the earth, but the heaven also." This means that all of creation will be shaken and be removed, so that only the unshakable things will remain. In other words, since we are receiving a kingdom, we are receiving something that is unshakable. Let us be thankful and please God by worshiping him with only fear and awe. For our God is a devouring fire. God is saying that he's going to give us something tangible, something unshakable, something that's eternal, something that is going to last even after the entire things in the world has been removed. He's giving us something substantial today. And God is asking us not to reject it. But in essence, since we are receiving it, that means God is already giving it unto us. And since you are collecting it, you are collecting this kingdom that is unshakable. Let us be thankful and please God with our worship by worshiping Him. So I'll go for the next 5 minutes. We are still going to worship God with this understanding. Say, Lord God, thank you for giving us that thing. We are receiving that thing that is unshakable. We are receiving a kingdom. God is giving unto us a kingdom. A kingdom that is unshakable. So we are saying, Lord God, we thank you. We thank you. We should worship you because we are receiving it. We say we should thank Him because we are receiving it. We are receiving that kingdom.
My son, the worship.
consagi que gede masanta ka shaka saka yada da masanta gike shepe consagi que gede masanta gika shaka que sere ponsaya masanta ka shape que seke gede masanta giko seke gede bo shepe que sekanda da mama 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 gike gede bo shepe que seri ka shagi que gede masanta gika gida bo seke gede masanta gike gede bo shepe ka saka gede da father And in my my KJV says, wherefore we receiving the kingdom which cannot be moved, let us have grace. Let us have grace. I also just underline that grace there. And in the book of Zechariah 12, verse 10, says, I will pour upon the house of David and upon the inhabitants of Jerusalem the spirit of grace and supplication. We're about to just speak the spirit of grace. And then in the book of Hebrews 4, he said, let us come both in the throne of grace, so you might obtain mercy and also find grace in the time of need. We are praying to God. We're not saying that God, because we've been praying for like a month or so, we're not saying that we've been praying for a month or so, that we have this right to receive what God wants to give to us. Not because we're praying for a month or 2 months or we're interceding. We don't have that right to receive anything. But we are actually coming to God as people in need of rekindling, people in need of sustenance, people in need of God to do something definite in their lives. That Lord God, we need your grace for this, for the meeting today, for the one tomorrow, for the one on Saturday, that your spirit of grace will be made manifest. It will be made manifest in our lives. He says, most gladly, therefore, will I glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. So we're not coming here to say that, oh, we have done this, we have done that. We're not coming here to say, God, we glory in the fact that we glory in the fact that we don't have strength. It is when we glory in this is that the power of Christ will be made manifest in us. When we glory in this, when you say that we want, when you admit that God, we don't have anything, we don't have any right that, that is when God's power can be made manifest. And that's what we're asking God for. We're asking God for His power. We're asking God for His power to be made manifest. So not for say, God, we need your grace, God. So we admit that we are weak. We admit that we don't have the strength that it requires. So Lord God, let your power be made manifest in our meeting today in the mighty name of Jesus. In our meetings tomorrow, in our meetings on Saturday, in the name of Jesus.
In Zechariah 12:10 says that the spirit of grace and of supplication, some other conditions is the spirit of prayer. So we're praying that Lord God, you pass your spirit of prayer upon us. because here we realize that even prayer itself is a spirit, that there's a spirit that enables one to pray. There's a spirit that backs, that enables one to be able to sit down for a long period of time and seek the face of the Lord. It's not something that we can talk and do by his own power. It's not something that, I just desire to pray and then you pray. But there's a spirit that God will give unto you that will allow you to, to stay, to press unto him, until what he has already said he's going to do in our life, until it comes to manifestation in the physical world. They're going to pray that, Lord God, you part your spirit of prayer upon us in the mighty name of Jesus. You part your spirit of prayer, the spirit of supplication upon every single person in the mighty name of Jesus. That Lord God give mother the strength to pray, the grace to pray. That God, you are going to give unto us in the mighty name of Jesus. You have already dedicated these 3 days to seeking the face of the Lord. You have dedicated these 3 days to seeking the face of the Lord in prayer. That means if you do not pray, that means what God is ready to do in this time might not be made available unto you. So I say, Lord God, the spirit of supplication that, Lord God, you make available to us in the mighty name of Jesus. My Santa, Lord God.
My son's agitation, 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 my Amen. We're going to be praying, and I'm going to be reading from, I'm going to be reading for the ministers of God. I'm going to be reading from the book of Acts 2, verse 37. And now when they heard this, they were pricked in their hearts, and they said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? And Acts 4, chapter 4 also says, and when they prayed, the place was shaking where they were assembled together, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. I want to emphasize on all, like all of them were filled with the Holy Ghost. Not they were filled, they were all filled. That's just everybody that was there was filled with the Holy Ghost. And they spoke the word of God with boldness, and the multitude of them that believed were of one heart, one soul. And none of them said anything, they posted anything. And verse 3 says that, and with great power gave the apostles witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ, and great grace was upon them all. It says that, verse 3 again, and with great power gave the apostles witness of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ, and great grace was upon them. That means there was a power that backed up their speaking of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ, and there was a grace that was upon them. And that's what we're going to use to pray for the ministers of God, that their speech that will be backed up with great power, that whatever that God has given them to say will be backed up with great power. In chapter 2:37, it says that on the earth is, they were putting their hands and said, what shall we do to be saved? There was a power that come upon them, that the words they said just had to affect the lives of people. And it says that, and there was a power, the great power that made them to speak, and a grace was upon them. I'm going to pray the same prayer points for the ministers that will be coming, that Lord God, there will be power will back up their words, that power will back up their words in the name of Jesus, that there will be a grace that will rest upon them in the name of Jesus, that what God has told us, has given unto them to speak unto us, what God, because everybody is coming here with with an hunger, with a desire, with expectations. And there is a power that backs up the words of the man, because you can come with an expectation and the man can be seeing something that will even match what you want, what you desire of God. But if there is no utterance, if there is no power, if there is no grace, you would miss it. But I pray that Lord God, you will do this unto this men of God that will be coming, even people that will be leading prayers from every prayer leader from every city. That Lord God, you are going to pray for yourself. And Lord God, you are going to back up my own words with power in the name of Jesus. You are going to back up the words of every minister of God with power. That grace will be upon them in the name of Jesus. The great and great grace will be upon them all, the apostles, the people that were in church. Lord God, great power, God. Father God, great power was given to the apostles so they could bear witness of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Great power was given unto them so they can say what? That was the message that God had given unto them. That was the message they had. We have any other message apart from the resurrection of Jesus Christ, apart from his death and his resurrection. That's all they were preaching. That's all they were preaching, and there was a power. That means they could have been preaching that same that message. But if there was no power, there would not be any effect. If there was no power, there would not be any effect. You are saying, Lord God, my Santa, he can't get the bush, we can't take it today. That Lord God, great power, Lord God, we back up their words in the name of Jesus. My Santa, he can't take it today. My Santa, he can't get the bush, he can't take it today. My Santa, he can't take it. And they prayed together, and the place in which they were assembled was shaking, and they were filled with the Holy Ghost, and they spoke the word of God with boldness. Father God, we are asking for a manifestation of your presence, Lord God. My son, Tagi, can get the bull shape, we can suck together. My son, Tagi, can get the bull shape, we can suck together. The Lord God, we want a bull shape, we can suck it up. My son, Tagi, can share it today. My son, Tagi, can share, we can suck it today. Oh, Lord God, mercy, we can suck it today. By your mercy, oh God, give me power to the words of your ministers in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, from the beginning to the end, everybody that will be talking, everybody that will be saying anything, that will be praying. Father God, even the choir, oh God, and the drama, oh Lord God, there will be good power in the name of Jesus. There will be good power in the back of the words in the name of Jesus. Great power, we back it up in the name of Jesus. Great power, we back it up in the name of Jesus. Great power, we back it up. And your grace will be made available. Oh Lord God, Oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, the place was shaking when they were assembled together, and it was filled with the Holy Ghost. We are going to be asking Lord God, God, even though this is an online meeting, that our lives will be shaken in the mighty name of Jesus. That Lord God, you will do something to us, that we will not live here the same way we have gathered. That even in our rooms, I believe in our rooms, oh God, that the power of the Holy Ghost will be made manifest. We will fill the atmosphere in the name of Jesus.
Amen. This is going to be our last prayer point for tonight. Thank God and start moving. So, yes. Verse Acts 4, verse 34. So, neither was there anyone alike amongst them, for they were possessors of lands and houses. For as many as were possessors of lands and houses sold them and brought the prices of the things that were sold. My point is that neither of any of them lacked. And then in verse 5, we see a Ananias and Sapphira, who, I don't know what happened to them. He said the devil put in their hearts to lie. But the thing about it, that one of the things I believe happened to them was that they lacked faith. They lacked faith that if they submit their all to God, if they submit everything to God, they will have provision. So they were just trying to just, and they will find ways to just make sure they are safe, and then they also still give to the church. And it just reminds me of how God can be willing and be ready to do something in the lives of people. God can be saying, okay, I want to do this at this particular point in time. But if people lack the faith to believe, what? Because, yeah, nobody was lacking anything, but these guys were scared that they were going to lack. And nobody was already lacking. That means God can make something readily available for you. But there's a place for us to receive it, you know, to believe it, first of all, and then to receive it. So we are praying to God that the spirit of faith, God, I will give unto every single person. Because if God has equipped the men of God with power, he has done everything to them,
because Ananias and Sapphira were still in the same church, or in the same church where everybody was being changed, where everybody was being transformed. And then that lack of faith in the power of Christ for provision, that means there's a lack. If the God is speaking healing, if you lack the faith to receive it, no matter how mighty that the man of God is, no matter how mighty the power is, you would not get it. You would not get the healing. You would not get the provision. You would not get what you have come from. So you're asking God, God, give us the spirit of faith, God. This faith to believe what you are ready to do. Faith to believe what you are going to do, that you will give unto us in the name of Jesus. Faith to believe what you are set to do in the name of Jesus, that you will give unto us in the name of Jesus. That Lord God, you have to you will give us faith, God. Because without faith, it's impossible to please God. Without faith, it's impossible to receive from God. But God, without faith, there must be a faith for souls. Someone must have the faith. If you are expecting healing from your family member, you must be the one that will have faith for that person. If you are believing some God for provision from your life, you must have faith for that thing to come, for that thing to be made available to you. So all we are asking God, Father God, the spirit of faith, God, let me be abundant to us. Let it be made available to us. Father God, let it be made available to us. In the name of Jesus, give me the worship. We call you. Faith to believe what you are ready to do, God. Give unto us in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father God, we mother bush, we can get a bosa, we can shake every day. Father God, help us to believe, God. Help us to believe, oh 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 God, what you are set to do. You are said to do at this particular point in time, what you are said to do in our lives. If you ever come with expectations from God and you don't believe that God will do it, you cannot receive it. Father God, we ask God that you give us faith, God, to believe every single thing you have promised. God is going to give us a kingdom unshakable, a kingdom that cannot be moved. That means if you don't believe it, you can't receive it. No matter how God has promised, unless a man will believe, unless a man will believe God, that is when it's going to be made available to him. Father God, give us faith, God. Father God, strengthen our faith, God. Increase our faith, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father God, we worship you. Father God, we give you praise. I want us to just begin to worship the name of the Lord. I want us to just begin to adore him. I want us to say, God, we thank you. God, we thank you. Oh God, we thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Holy Spirit of God. We thank you for what you are set to do. We thank you. Because this day we have been waiting for months now is finally here. This day that you have made, this day that you have created, Father God, this day that you have made available to every single one of us is finally here. Father God, we say thank you. Father God, we say thank you. Father God, we say thank you. Man Santa, he calls shepherd, he can say, Kaida, Boshe, he can say, Kedday. Father God, we say thank you. Father God, we say thank you. Father God, we say thank you. Man Santa, he can say, Kedday. Father God, we adore you. Man Santa, he can say, Yabo, so he can say, Kedday. Man Santa, he can say, Kedday. Mama, Santa, he calls up, he can say, Kedday. Father God, we are grateful. Father God, we are grateful. I just want us to say, God, we thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father God, oh God, we worship you. We worship you, Ancient of Days. We worship you, I am that I am. We worship you, King of Glory. Man Shanta, we can say, we call Sabre, Keshe, we can say, we get a day. Man Shanta, we can say, Kasha, we can get a day. Father God, we worship you, Jesus. 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 Father God, we worship you. We thank you, Ancient of Days. We thank you, King of Glory. Father God, we have a bush of coals that we can get today. My sons are we can get a bush of coals that we can get today. Father God, we worship you. We worship you. Father God, we thank you. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. My Santa, you can get a worship because Sagi can get a worship. We can say, my Santa, you can get a worship. We can say, my Santa, you worship. We can say, can get a day. My Kasha, we can say, can get a day. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Father, thank you. Thank you, oh Lord. Thank you, oh Jesus. Thank you, oh Jesus. Thank you, 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 Jesus. Hallelujah. Be unto your name. Praises be unto your name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen.